having laid siege at the gate to the university by these thugs and the tear gas that followed, everywhere in the community was already charged. All able-bodied men and women had gathered in various locations wondering what is going on. And as the governor's entourage was driving in a bus to my house, these bike riders that the deputy governor arranged, we also followed them in the entourage. And so all of this explained the reaction of those youth. And from what they told me, the two of the people that I had reported to the police over the attack at my residence in Benin were also in that bus, and they could see them. And the problem with a mob, they can't distinguish between the invited guest, the responsible people, highly placed people that I respect, I hold in very, very high esteem. They can't distinguish them from those two gentlemen who, well, I'm not sure whether I can still describe them as gentlemen. They can't distinguish them from those two guys who, you know, I had complained to the police about their role in the attack on my Benin residence 2 weeks ago. Now, my purpose this afternoon or this evening is simply to, again, apologize to all those who were embarrassed, but just to suggest to the governor that, as I told him in a text message, we do not need to import thugs. We do not need thugs. He has to prevail on his deputy, who seems to have a higher propensity for violence, to change his ways. This I have already sent to him. Because what will you gain on a convocation day to import thugs to a university environment? Even if INEC has already blown whistle for election, which is not the case in Edo, you don't want to go to university premises to organize a rally. So why import thugs to a convocation ceremony? It's unheard of.